Macca's guides.
Hey guys, Macca here. Playing Watch Dogs 2, I'm going to be taking you through all 24 points of key data in the Hidden World. Unlocking all 24 will get you the Researcher Achievement / Trophy. And most of these are going to be pretty simple, but there's a couple that are quite difficult and a little bit tricky. The first one I'm going to be showing is Vehicle Directional Hacking, which you will attain during one of the first main missions in the game as part of the main quest line. You'll go into this garage in Embarcadero Center. Just go inside the garage and pick it up. Now the next two upgrades I'll be showing you are Speed Boost and Enhanced Spring for the RC Jumper, and you'll need these to access certain areas for later key data, which is why I'm showing these two first, and then after that I'll just be going in order around the circle in the skill trees. So in Alcatraz, we can find the speed boost for the RC jumper by going inside, going to the top floor, and then finding a jail cell with a hole in it, taking our RC jumper into that hole, and then unlocking and hacking the little box inside. Next, I'll be showing you Enhanced Spring in Palo Alto. This one's going to allow your RC jumper to jump a little bit higher, and you can see it on the map here, not far from where our marker is. Sometimes you'll find the key data quite close to where the marker is on the map, but sometimes it'll be a good distance away, up to 300 or 400 meters. What you'll want to do is, from this corner of the building, either use a forklift or a car to move one of these two boxes out of the way. I'd recommend this white box if you have the same setup as me, making sure you don't push the blue box too far in. At this point, just walk in and go behind to hack the console. You can also use some explosives here if you don't have a forklift or a car to move the boxes with, and just blow everything away. As soon as you do that, you can now walk out of this box, hack a camera, and use that camera to hack the top of the tower from a distance to get this key data. So now that we've gotten those three out of the way, I'll be starting with remote control, going around the skill tree clockwise, meaning that expert RC engineering at the Sutro Tower is next. You'll want to hop the fence in one of the corners and then use your RC jumper car in order to gain access into this small building that I'm on top of via a small break in the side, and then picking up the key data. So this next one's going to be remote gadgets available at the ferry building, and this one will require you to have the flying drone. As soon as you see the tower, try to get pretty close to the tip so you don't lose range, but just use your drone and fly up to the hack point and hack the point in order to get the data. Next up, we have massive vehicle hack in Chinatown. For this one, you will want to go into this alleyway that's actually quite far away from the core of Chinatown, go up a small ladder, hack a small box, and then use your RC jumper as well as your boost and enhanced spring in order to get across a large gap where you can then open a small grate or go underneath the patio and hack the piece of data you need. Next up, we have botnet savings for vehicle hacks on Yerba Buena Island. This one's not too bad. You can try to go in and stealth and kill everyone, or you can be a little bit cheap and just send in your RC jumper to do all the dirty work for you. Next up, we have Chopper Retreat by the San Francisco Museum of Modern Art. In an alleyway behind it, you should be able to find a small gang and a container with a vehicle in it. If you use the vehicle directional hack to get the vehicle out of the container and then hop inside, you can find this data in the back corner of the blue container. Next up is botnet savings for personal devices in the Swan Leave It Observatory area. If you just approach from the very back, you should be able to just make a break straight for the data. You might get hit a couple of times, but as long as you pick it up, you'll have it forever. And feel free to use distractions on any enemies that might see you. I actually almost made it without being spotted, but made a stupid mistake and didn't really think it through. But oh well, you'll just go right up to it and pick it up. Next up is Gang War in Elmhurst. This one's super easy. You'll literally just approach from one direction. You can crouch in and grab it and crouch out without barely making a sound. And this one's gonna be super easy. Massive system crash in the Gates Houseboats area. This one's actually going to be on top of the Chopper Bike clothing store. And to get to this one, we'll need to use the forklift, which should be nearby in the alley between the auto repair and the bike shop. And you should be able to control this, so you'll need one of the previous things we've unlocked. And you'll need to pick up a container and move it into a specific place and raise it up so that you can use it as a stepping platform to get up top. Once on top of the roof, we'll need to get into the small area here and then use our RC drone in order to go through the crack and hack the small box. After we hack the small box, we can open the metal grate, and inside of the metal grate, we can hack the data. For system crash upgrade blackout at Jack London Square, all we really need to do here is sprint directly towards it. We can try to sneak to it, or we can use our RC jumper car to drive up to it. It's up to you. I found that just literally running to it was actually a pretty viable strategy. For security system shutdown at the New Dawn facility, aka the Scientology facility, you'll be able to easily grab this on one of the missions where you come here, or if you want to do it when, you know, not during that mission, you might have missed it, or you want to do it before the mission. Just go into the base with your RC jumper car, drive up to it and pick it up, or you can do it the hard way by trying to sneak in or using cameras to hack people and objects so that you can just try to stealthily approach it. Using your RC jumper car is going to be probably the easiest though.
Recent leaks of confidential emails has had unexpected consequences for HMP Studios. Contents of the documents expose an ongoing contentious collaboration with Galilei, the company responsible for the expensive high-tech car featured in the studio's latest blockbuster, Cyberdriver. The emails reveal that a studio executive...
Now we have botnet savings for city hacking, and this one's taking place at Fort Point. You'll want to approach from this side of the area, and you'll notice that there is a door. that door is going to be completely locked and you'll need to hack it using this box. Now, the only way you can hack it, you might be able to get a couple of points to move properly. You will, however, need the drone in order to make this happen. And I just kind of winged it here, but what you'll need to do, and generally the best strategy, is to follow the blue line and find out where the blue line turns into a red line and then fix the problem. And that's the best way you're always going to be able to do it, in my opinion. Just keep following the blue line. Make sure it turns into once it turns into a red line, just make sure it turns into a blue line and continue that until you get further and further. If you get lost at a certain point, you might try to want to work backwards. So work from where you're trying to end up at the very end of the red point on the door, and then work backwards to find out how the path is going to make its way back to the end of the circuit. So just keep flying around. I do show the perfect solution as you would do it in about 2 minutes here, and it's not that bad, actually, as long as you're following along and paying attention to all the points. It's not that bad. Again, like I said, the best strategy, follow the blue until it turns red to make it blue, and then work backwards if you're really, really stuck. And that should be it. Once you unlock the entire pattern, you can open the door, walk inside, and pick it up. Expert tinkering at Vista Point. For this one, you'll want to go under the bridge. You will need enhanced spring and speed boost, which were the second and third upgrades we unlocked in this video. You'll want to go into this base and you'll have to make a series of a couple of complex jumps in order to pick it up using your RC jumper. If you find that you're getting shot a lot by a lot of the enemies, just make sure you're distracting them with hacks so that they don't pay attention to you as you drive by.
Set with this shit.
Electroshock optimization at the Crystal Springs Dam. This is another one where we'll need the speed boost and the enhanced spring on our RC jumper car. You'll make your way into the dam, and I would imagine that you'd want to approach from behind so that you end up nearest the key data as soon as you enter the facility, so you won't have to make your way through very much. And then as soon as you do that, you're basically just going to have to do a little bit of a tricky jump through a window. And as soon as you get your RC jumper through the window, you're basically home free, and that's all you really need to worry about. But that jump is going to be a little bit tricky. What I found is the best way is absolutely you need to get up onto these two boxes here, then aim for the window, do a tiny speed boost and a big jump, and you should be able to get in pretty easily. Once you get in, you can either hack the red box to allow yourself entrance into the room so you can pick up the data, or you can just pick up the data using your RC jumper and then just walk away. For 17, we have Tweaked Blast on Lombard Street. And this one isn't too bad. As soon as you have access to the street, just pull out your drone and fly right up to the top of the building and find it under a patio. Next up is explosive optimization at Galilee, and this one can actually be a little bit difficult because there's a lot of armed enemies here. There's a couple snipers, there's some dudes with like legit body armor that won't get killed very easily. So you want to try to sneak your way in, and the best way to do that is on this ledge by going around, using a lot of distractions, setting a lot of traps, and just timing your enemy movements properly. And as soon as you do that, you want to make your way to the very top of this kind of tower that I'm right next to so that you can hack a CTOS box so that you can then use your drone to hack the tower. There is a sniper that I don't pay attention to, unfortunately, because I miss him. You'll probably want to melee him, which I don't do. But as soon as you unlock that CTOS box I was talking about, make your way back out of the complex the same way that we made our way in. And once you're home free, use your drone in order to hack the tower and then quickly run away.
Shit! Everybody, alert! We have an intruder! Back up, here. Oh! You hear that? Get out! Hey! This guy should be here! Intruder! Over here!
Let's finish this.
Description of the target is incoming.
Next up is Steady Hands at Kirby Cove. Yet another super easy one. Once you find the location, which is a little bit far off of the Kirby Cove area, you should be able to literally just drive in with your RC jumper car. It's that easy. You don't even need to come up these stairs like I did. Just drive in and pick it up. Hopefully you don't get torn apart by the dogs. But if you have the enhanced spring and the speed boost, the dogs shouldn't be an issue. Keen Eyes at Noodle Park. For this one, you want to make your way to the little back area lot where there's a bunch of security guards running around, and it's a no-no zone marked in red. And for this one, yet another one, we're just going to use our RC car. You can't actually even pick this one up by hand if you wanted to. Jump the fence on the side, then get into the container in the back through the small crack and pick it up. Then call your RC drone back and you're home free. Strong Grip, available at the Cult Tower. Yes, you guys guessed it. Use your RC jumper car in order to drive up to the data and pick it up. Target Weakness, available at the Cliff House. Yet again, yes, you guys guessed it, use your RC car to drive up to the data and pick it up. For this one, you do probably have to distract some of the guards with traps and with their phone distractions in order to be able to make sure you get through without them shooting you. So this one might be a little bit more tricky, but generally it's the same concept as before. Fast Trigger is available in the Prescott area, and for this one, what we'll want to do is once we reach the area, yet again, pull out your RC jumper car, use some distractions, some traps, and just pick it up. Yes, you can try to go in there and sneak attack them or melee enemies. All of that ends up being completely useless and a waste of your time, though, because the fastest way by far is to hack people and just run right up to it.
Yeah, real clever.
Last but not least, we have Stun Amp Up at Stanford University. And this one's a long one, but actually a lot of fun. Hopefully you can figure some of this out yourself, but I'm going to guide you through it nonetheless. It involves a couple of steps, and it involves some out-of-the-box thinking. The first thing we're going to need to do is start in front of the large building and use our RC car in order to get up the back through a metal grate into some of the duct system, and then we can interact with the CTOS box in order to unlock one of the puzzles that are available on the map. After that, we'll use our drone. So now that we unlocked that box, we have to get right up next to the building and use our drone in order to solve the puzzles. This one's a little bit more difficult because it does make us have to solve like four different sides all at the same time. So the strategy of using red until it turns to blue isn't as easy as it might have been before. Another really, really annoying thing is that you have to go all the way to the top of the tower with the drone in order to interact with some of the points you unlock up there. But as soon as you get high enough to interact with these points, you lose range and then your drone like dies. So that's really annoying. But again, our strategy here is to generally find a point where we can adjust some stuff. And like, you're trying to unlock the locks and you're going to try to unlock the simplest of locks first, which are going to be the ones on the ground to the side of the large tower. And the trick here is to move the cars using vehicle directional hacking in order to unlock as many locks as possible, and then work your way up the side of the tower until you unlock all four sides of the top of the tower. And then once you do that, you can lead your way back down the front face of the tower towards the door that we need to unlock. If you follow along with the video, it's not as bad as it might sound when I talk about it, because it sounds a lot more confusing than it is. And it's actually a really fun puzzle to solve, but then once you unlock all that stuff, I'll take you through the next step. So now that we've unlocked the entire tower in the blue lines and unlocked the door at the front on the little balcony area, we now want to switch back to our RC jumper, which mine's actually going to be a little bit outside of the vents. Yours might still be inside of the vents, but just take it, go around the outside of the ledge of this area through the door, and then pick up your last key data. Hopefully you had as much fun doing this as I did. Drop a like if the video was helpful. Thank you guys so much for watching. Share the video with a friend. Special thanks to Drop That Artemis for supporting the show on Patreon, and hopefully I see you guys next time. Peace.